Unfortunately for me, we're back again to look at the brakes. The problem is, I have a squeal on my front brakes. I did do a normal bedding process, 60 to 20 miles an hour, about 7 or 8 times, let them cooled. I don't believe it's warped rotors. There could be a rotor issue, but I'm going to go ahead and try a couple free fixes today just to see if I can solve it without having to buy new rotors or go any deeper into this. So I'm going to show you a couple fixes I like to try to solve squeaking brakes. First thing we're going to do is resurface the rotors, just a real kind of backyard mechanic type method, nothing fancy. Unfortunately, this time we do have to take off the caliper carrier, which is 221 millimeters. These are real tight. I just checked the torque on these just for fun, and it's 147 foot-pounds for these big bolts. So luckily you have a lot of play here in the front to work your ratchets up and down. That's a lot of torque. And incidentally, the caliper pins torque at 22 foot-pounds. It's 30 pneumatic and converted. It's 22 foot-pounds. If you want to get real technical here, make sure everything's perfect. So I'm going to break this caliper carrier off first. Once your carrier is off, you can go ahead and give it some more cleaning. Get it nice and shiny again, because this probably, hopefully, won't come off too often at all on any car you have. So just clean it up, and we'll work on taking off the disc next. Now to get your disc off, you will have a T30, and you got one little set screw here. Comes off real easy. Easier than those Phillips ones that can be real easy to strip out. Luckily this is a Torx, so I got my screw out. Gently wiggle it and it'll come off, and we'll examine the disc next. What we have here are Scotch-Brite 3M surfacing conditioning discs. I got these 10-15 years ago. I don't use them too often, but in case you want to maybe look for some part numbers on it, stuff like that. And you get a little drill chuck, so I'm going to go ahead and do these rotors. What you want to do here is take away some of these lines here. It's a real basic roughing it up kind of thing. Sometimes if the disc gets real shiny, you can cause squeaks, so let me get this set up and do it properly. Again, you're just trying to take the mirror finish off of these, make them not quite so shiny, let the pads wear in again. Doesn't have to be too much here. In the old days, I do this with sandpaper, but of course that'll take far longer. It's not quite as uniform as this. This is just real nice here. So you just kind of got a circular kind of pattern on that. Take off some of the glaze. The other thing you can do to combat noise, much more common, is your brake disc quiet. Now this tube is probably 10 to 15 years old, but it's all the same stuff. I'm probably not going to use this particular tube. Then I got a few packs from the Hawk pads I've had over the years, high temperature brake lubricant grease, and the number one instruction here says to silence brake noise. Put some on the back side of the pads. And You might also see a CRC, synthetic brake caliper grease, prevents brake noise. So there's all different ways, all different kinds of greases you can use. I'm going to rip open a brand new Hawk pack, so I know this stuff is sort of fresh, red. You only want the grease where anything's touching, otherwise there's no point at all. So on this pad, the circular markings here is where the piston hits. And you definitely don't want to overdo it. All it'll do is squirt out and make a mess. So I like to just do a real light finger coat, maybe a little more, so at least it has some color to make sure it's somewhat worth it. But don't squeeze it all over it in big globs, because it's just going to squeeze out and make a mess of your brakes anyway next time you got to work on them. So I got a nice bead around all the contact points, little gel. I might use just a little bit more. And that's about it. I'm going to pop this into the caliper, then I'll do the same to the other one. So then for the other pad, you just have your two caliper arms which go here and here. So I'll just lay in a bead here and here. A little more on the top, because the caliper is going to slide on and smear it down anyway. So if you're going to put a little extra, you put it at the top, it's going to naturally smear down. Put those right on the contact points, and hopefully this will solve the slow squeal I have under real light brake pressure. When you press harder, the squeal goes away, but when you're just floating to a stop, it's really annoying. It starts to whine really loud. So this is my best attempt. Hopefully I'll get lucky, and hopefully you can solve some of your brake squeals also.